Hello students, welcome to the world of virtual banking. In this topic, we will study the technology of mobile banking, virtual banking and electronic fund transfer system. Let us start with the mobile banking services. Mobile banking service is provided by bank or other financial institutions to perform various financial transactions by using mobile phone or tablet. Software which is required to use mobile banking service is known as app. Some financial institutions keep restrictions on accounts which can be accessed by mobile and limit on amount of transactions. The earliest mobile banking concept was limited with banking service as SMS. Nowadays, with the help of WAP, that is Wireless Application Protocol support, smartphones can handle different online transactions. Protocol is a list of technical standards to access information with the help of wireless applications. Let us check the general list of transactions of mobile banking. With mobile banking app, it is easy to check the account balances of the different types of bank accounts. User can easily check the list of latest performed transactions in a specific period of time. Customer can pay different bill payments with the use of cards provided by banks. It is easy to transfer the funds from customer's account to the other person's account. User can easily download the important transaction data in the form of statements for the official purpose or for personal records. Bank provides the facility of sending alert messages to users for account related activities. User can check the term deposits maturity dates. Bank provides loan statements on mobile as per the demand of customer. User can get data of different card types which are used for payments. It is easy to track the process flow and to get the current status of request for credit and loan approval. With mobile banking, user can send the request for checkbook or credit card. Exchange of data messages and email, including user complaints, submission and tracking. Online facility is provided to send the information about nearby ATM locations at customer's area. User is able to deposit the checks with mobile app. Now let us discuss immediate payment system, which can be used with mobile banking facility. This system is used in India to transfer funds in different banks via mobile apps. It is a real-time transaction system. This service is available 24/7 for the customers to transfer the funds throughout the year, which includes all public and bank holidays as well as Reserve Bank of India holidays. NPCI, that is National Payments Corporation of India, handles this system. This payment service is different from NEFT and RTGS, as it does not need to follow any time limit to carry out the transactions. Nowadays, some banks have also started providing IMPS service with online banking services. Mostly all banks offer this service free of cost, but some banks like ICICI, Axis banks are charging some cost for IMPS. With online banking, funds can be transferred directly by using bank account number and IFS code. In this case, fund receivers do not need to register for mobile banking service with his bank. Friends, Please check academic script for detailed workflow of immediate payment system. Friends, what are the different advantages of mobile banking? First, it minimizes the bank cost of handling of transactions as customer visits reduces at bank premises. Second, bank provides this service as a free of cost. No limit is set for number of times customer can access his account. Next, some banks assure that by downloading the app directly from the server, the data won't be stored in customer mobile as well as in SIM card. Fourth, e-banking app uses advanced encryption technologies which makes safe and secure transactions. Now let us discuss some limitations of mobile banking. If proper data care measures are not taken by banks, then it may cause harmful for the customer's personal data. Customer need to learn use of internet and handling of websites. Now let us discuss test case related with the mobile banking. A businessman needs to travel across the regions for his business related work. He has different types of accounts with few banks. It is a need of business to maintain these different accounts for multiple transactions. Many times it becomes difficult to carry out banking transactions with personal visit at the bank premises. He always needs instant information about account balances, list of latest transactions, status of funds transfer from the customer and to the other accounts, and different statements of accounts. On the basis of this information, he is able to take quick decisions regarding the financial terms. Many times he uses debit or credit cards for multiple transactions instead of cash. For security purpose and cash flow information, he needs to check card transactions reports. To run the business smoothly, he wants to manage his financial transactions efficiently. But in traveling, many times it is difficult to carry and use laptop. Due to this, he is not able to keep track of the bank related transactions frequently. To solve this problem, now he uses mobile banking facility to process all bank transactions. Now let us move ahead with virtual banking concept. Virtual banking concept is related with the use of banking facilities with the help of internet. Nowadays in India, most of the banks are providing virtual banking facility to their customers. This service is available for 24 hours. So, customer can use it as per his time convenience. Apart from the traditional services offered by banks, it provides different services like payment services for different e-shops and e-malls on behalf of their customers. Now let us check services provided by virtual banking. ATM, automated teller machine. User can withdraw and deposit money with his bank's ATM. Also, he can withdraw money from different banks' ATM, but with the certain limitation on number of transactions. This service is available for 365 days. It is a need of customer to get the financial services after bank hours also. For this purpose, banks are providing different types of ATM services like cash withdrawal, cash deposit, printing of passbook, balance inquiry, request for checkbook and general statements of account, etc. Bank has provided ATM card with a PIN to perform all these transactions. Customer can use different types of cards for various payments. Example, credit card, debit card and ATM card. Electronic fund transfer system. This online system is used to transfer the funds from customer's account to the same or different customer's account or from one organization to other organization's account. Internet banking. With this system, customer can complete his bank transactions with the use of internet facility. User can handle different types of transactions like transfer of funds, checking of current status of account, online request for loan or different types of cards or checkbook. Let us discuss different categories of bank services. First, person to person. Fund transfer from one customer's account to other customer's account with the same bank or with different bank's account. Second, person to business. It includes merchant payment and utility bill payment. Card payment method is also used for these transactions. Next, business to person. These transactions include salary deposit, commission deposit, etc. Next, government to person. Customer can pay online different government taxes, such as filling online ITR, that is income tax return, VAT, service tax, professional tax, etc. Now let us discuss importance of virtual banking. Efficient and rapid access for cash flow reviews, auditing and daily financial transaction processing. It provides ease of access of the system, security for transaction data, and it is available for 24 hours. Business personnel can make financial decisions with updated information. With quick online updates, it is easy to note errors or delays and can resolve quickly. Productivity is high due to easy and quick access, as banks are using improved technology for online banking. With online search tools, it is easy to get information about banking auction programs. Search tools are also used to research transactions and resolve banking related problems. It reduces errors which occur due to manual mistakes. It's due to poor handwriting or mistaken information. It provides clear visibility into banking activities, which reduces frauds. Friends, what are the advantages of virtual banking? Operation cost per service is lower for bank because of less overhead expenses. No need to visit bank premises personally. Customers can get funds anytime with ATM. Customer can get retail outlets discount with the use of debit or credit card. Customer can easily transfer funds from one place to another place. Transaction can be checked in real time. No need to wait for a day or month to end to check transaction details. Response time has increased with the use of improved technology. This service is available for round the clock. Customer can access it as per his time convenience. Now let us discuss main factors to use virtual banking in India. Better services. Banks provide better and quick online services in the form of high speed of transactions, instant solution of a problem, and quick response to the customer queries. Better access to services. Main focus of banks is to provide quick and better access to the available online services. This can be achieved with the use of best quality technology. Better prices. User needs to pay internet connection charges while using online banking facility, but these charges are generally minimum, depend on the internet pack used by the user. Higher privacy. banks do not share the customers or transactions data with any other sources. It maintains the higher privacy of data. Banks' marketing activities. Virtual banking is the best platform to introduce new products, policies of the banks. To attract the customers, banks are focusing on online advertisement and product details and policies. Now let us discuss different virtual data threats. First, virus attacks. Viruses are executable programs which are harmful for data as well as computer system also. Virus attacks can be possible with infected files or emails. When user copies the virus infected files from different computers in a device like pen drives or downloading of attachments which contains the virus infected data, this may cause to the virus attacks to damage user's data or computer system. Second, backdoor viruses. After repairing of infected data by antivirus, some viruses leaves infected executable files in the system. These infected executable files contains virus data, which can be dangerous for the newly created data or next version of data. Next, hacking of data. In this type, hackers adds the unwanted data with huge size or makes multiple copies of same data on a web server, which overflows the memory storage space. Due to this, it shows the denial of service message to the users. In this situation, user is not able to access the web server. Next, phishing. User receives fraud emails asking about the bank details and login ID password details. While considering it as an authorized official email from bank, if user replies with the correct data, this data can be used for illegal purpose or for illegal financial transactions. Next, blended. These are combined attacks from two or more threats. To overcome these virus and threats problem, user needs to take proper care while performing online transactions. Along with this, banks also need to adopt security technologies for safe transactions. What is data security? Data security is the most important part of the virtual transactions. Different security techniques are used to transfer data from user's computer to bank's server. Some of the following techniques are: first, firewall. It is made up with software and hardware technology. It works as a barrier between intranet and internet. Intranet is an internal network, that is personal network of an organization. It protects the internal system from unauthorized users to use the data or information. It also protects the system from virus attacks. Next, cryptography. This security system protects the data while changing it into non-readable format. This process is also known as encryption process. Computer uses this encryption process before sending data over the wire. Destination computer changes the data format again into readable form. This process is known as decryption. It protects the data from the hackers to use the data for illegal purposes. User ID and password. To access a particular system or email accounts, valid user ID and password are used to log in into the system. User should use a strong password which cannot be easily cracked by the other users. It is suggested to change the password frequently. Defining data access levels. Different levels of users are maintained to share the data. These levels are depending on the data requirement and nature of work related with the data. This technique protects the data as well as it controls the data used for illegal purpose. Antivirus. Viruses are executable programs which are designed to damage data and computer system seriously. Antivirus programs are used to control the virus attacks. User should update the antivirus time to time to control threats. Friends, let us discuss test case regarding online banking. An employee of IT company not able to visit bank premises personally for loan inquiry and process related information due to his busy work schedules. He is not able to manage to meet with an authorized representative of bank. To solve this problem, now he is taking help of online portal of bank. All the details regarding the loan processes are present on a web page. Also, he can discuss his queries online with the bank representatives. He is able to send the required documents with this online process. He can easily track the progress of his loan related work. Friends, now let us discuss the next topic, EFT, that is Electronic Fund Transfer System. Electronic Fund Transfer System is used to transfer money from one bank account to another within a single financial institution or across multiple institutions with the use of computer-based system. It also deals with the electronic bill payment, store value transactions for electronic money. Store value card is a payment card with a monetary value stored on the card itself. Let us discuss payment systems covered under electronic fund transfer system. First, cardholder. Transactions are completed with payment cards as credit or debit card. Second, direct deposit. Direct fund transfer to payee's account. Payer would also add reference information as account number, an invoice number and payer's name, etc. Third, wire transfer. It is used for immediate settlement of cost. It is likely to be RTGS, that is real-time gross settlement, where real-time and final settlement is possible by posting the gross, that is complete entry against electronic accounts with the use of internet. It is wire transfer via an international banking network such as SWIFT, that is Society for Worldwide Interbank Financial Telecommunication. It deals with sending and receiving information about transactions of the financial institutions in a secure, standardized and reliable environment. Example, Central Bank Wire Transfer System. NEFT, that is National Electronic Fund Transfer. In this system, fund transfer is done via electronic messages. This system works in a batch of transactions. This system is not like RTGS, that is real-time gross settlement. It takes some time to complete the transactions according to the batch it belongs to. This facility is provided to the bank customers to transfer funds easily and securely on one-to-one basis. Under this scheme, individuals, firms and corporate can electronically transfer funds from any bank branch to any individual, firm or corporate having an account with any other bank branch in the country participating in the National Electronic Fund Transfer Scheme. Some charges are applicable for this transaction to the customer who wants to transfer the funds. These charges are depending on the amount which customer want to transfer. Friends, please refer academic script for detailed steps of NEFT process. What are the advantages of electronic fund transfer system? With online transactions, data can be reflected within the different accounts simultaneously. It helps to get an idea about the current status of the transactions. It improves the efficiency of bank staff as well as time span, which is required to complete the transactions. It leads to the customer's satisfaction. An online transaction reduces the labor cost of handling the work manually. It also reduces the additional cost which occurs due to manual errors of bank staff, which can lead to repetitive work. Banks are using different security techniques to protect the transaction data from the hackers, which may use it for illegal purposes. Security techniques like firewall, user ID password, cryptography, etc. are used by banks. Now let us discuss test case regarding the electronic fund transfer system. Mr. A is a businessman. He needs to pay different government taxes within specific period of time to avoid penalties. It is difficult for him to visit personally at different government offices to pay these taxes and to track out the processes. One of his friends introduced him with electronic fund transfer system to transfer funds from his bank account directly. Now, it is very easy for him to process government tax payments with electronic fund transfer system. Friends, now ending this topic with the conclusion, electronic banking is a need of today's world. So, wish you safe and secured e-banking transactions. Thank you.